It's what it is, you know. It's part of boxing.
So you're doing commentating for HBO Latino, Robert.
Correct.
You've done commentating for BKB. You've done commentating for other...
I've done for HBO Latino, too.
Oh, what's it like? How do you prepare for this?
Nah, it's you know, it's easy. I'm not saying it's gonna be that easy, because sometimes with, especially right now that we have like Russians, we have a guy from Germany, you know, to pronounce their names in Spanish. Yeah, we have a guy from Germany. He's now Germany resident.
Karo.
Yeah.
How do you pronounce?
Yeah, but he's from
he's from Germany, but he's Turkish German.
Yeah, no, well, he lives in Germany, but he was Armenia. He was born in Armenia.
Yeah,
he was born in Armenia.
Oh, he's training?
Who?
No, he's gonna fight tomorrow.
Yeah,
he's fighting tomorrow. Yeah. So it's hard to pronounce names, and you know, it's a little bit difficult. I know, but it's hard, you know.
If you ever need help,
it's hard, you know. We can
help you with the names, Robert.
Then we have the guy, the first fight. That's another one that's gonna be. He's from Russia. Yeah. So you know, so that could, might be a little bit difficult. You know, opponents that they fight, you know, in rush. So, you know, that could be a little bit difficult, but the rest should be fine. You know, we got some Latinos, you know, Barrera, I could pronounce. Campa, I could pronounce, you know. So we should be fine.
What do you think about the rise of the Eastern European fighters in the last few years in boxing?
Look, I think it was, we had the, you know, with Manny Pacquiao bringing all the Filipinos, but there was only one Manny Pacquiao, and there has been another one, not even close. With Argentinians, same thing, you know. We had Martinez, who was huge, then Maidana, Matisse. I think that could be coming to an end. With the Europeans, you know, the Russians, it's not just one or two. It's a lot of them. I think that's something that's the only one that I could say it's not coming to an end anytime soon. They're gonna continue for the next 10 years, because we got young ones right now that are turning pro tomorrow. We got one that's 10-0 that's got another 10 years of Mean Machine.
I heard the top ranks are the hardest hitting guy that they have.
I'm not the one saying it. Yeah, top ranks started saying that, and he's proving that he
9
that
knockouts he out of 10 fights.
Yeah, no, and the way he does it, you know, he's not like referee stops conscious. He lays those guys out. He's one that's gonna be around for another 10 years if he wants. And they have, you know, we have guys training pro. So I think with the Europeans, you know, Russians, we have more years to come with these guys. You know, the Filipino already went through. The Argentines, I think, is going to an end. So you know, these guys are taking over. They have something in them. You know, they turn pro. They don't turn pro at 18. They turn pro at 25, 26. So that's a big advantage for them. So they could fight. They could fight for a good 7-8 years and do great. You know, look at Triple G, 33 and still on top of his game. So.
So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Secback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter @Secback. And you can follow me on Instagram @EllieSecback.